वेलकम टू ऑल माय डियर भैया बहन, हाउ आर यू? ओके, वेरी फाइन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द न्यू चैप्टर आई वुड लाइक टू आस्क यू सम क्वेश्चंस एंड देन यू हैव टू से विच चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट टुडे। The first question goes to you. Suppose after finishing your education you are become a doctor and an enemy comes to you as your patient. What will you do? Will you think to kill him or will you think to save him? Very good. Somebody has told that they will kill him. Somebody told that if they will become a doctor, they will do their duty as a doctor does. A doctor's duty is to see the patient whether it is enemy or it is friend. So my dear, a man who is in job is bounded by his duty. If you will not perform your duty well, whatever you are assigned to, you can't fulfill your aim in your life. So can you say which chapter we are going to start today? Yes, very good. The enemy. This story is written by Pearl S. Buck. Pearl S. Buck's full name is Pearl Sindenstreicher Buck. She was born in 1892 and died in 1973. She was an American writer and novelist. She had a Chinese name, Sai Zhenzhu, as she spent her childhood in China being the daughter of missionaries. She was awarded the Pulitzer Prize in 1932 and the Nobel Prize in Literature in the year 1938. Now we should see the introduction of this story. Here the writer presents the time of the World War. An American prisoner of war is washed ashore in a dying state and is found at the doorstep of a Japanese doctor. Should he save him as a doctor or hand him over to the army as a patriot? See what the writer asks to you. The story is set during the Second World War. A Japanese doctor finds an American prisoner of war at his doorstep. He is in dilemma that being a doctor, should he save the wounded man? Or being a Japanese, should he hand over the enemy to the army? My dear, we all know that Japan is an enemy of America and America is an enemy of Japan. And you must remember one incident that America dropped atom bomb at Hiroshima and Nagasaki, which is in Japan. So they were enemies. American government tried several times to start friendship with Japan, but it is too difficult for Japan to start friendship with America, because when America comes to start friendship, Japanese people start remembering that incidents which took place in 1945 at Hiroshima and Nagasaki. America dropped atom bomb there, and still today the child who is born there, they are still physically handicapped. So how can you make friendship with such type of country? But my dear, you are a doctor. Can a doctor see that he is treating an enemy or he is treating a friend? No, my dear. All the doctors are bounded by their duties, and we all know that duty is beauty. We all teachers are in this long period, you are watching that we are working on online education. Why? Because we teachers are also bounded by our duties. If we shall not provide you material in time, you can't prepare your lesson well. If you can't prepare your lesson well, you can't answer in your examination. And if you will not answer in the examination, your result will become zero. Your outcome will become zero. Nobody will think that you were in lockdown period. Everybody will say they destroyed their times during lockdown period. They didn't use their time. They spent their time only watching mobiles. They didn't watch lessons on mobiles. They must watch something different on mobiles, people will say to you. So if my duty is to finish the lesson well, it is also the duty of students to finish their lesson well by writing question answers, by providing HW to subject teachers, by practicing letter writing, notice writing, advertisement writing, article writing, speech writing, debate writing. If you will be unable to perform your duties well, my dear, you don't think that your result will be well. So, on this earth, everybody is bounded by his duty. If we will not do our duty well, our result will not be well. So this story is about a doctor whose name is Dr. Sadao Hoki. He belongs to Japan, and what kind of doctor he was, whose treatment he had done in his life being a Japanese, why did he save the enemy, such story we are going to read today. Now see the lesson. The lesson starts with Dr. Sadao Hawke's house was built on a spot of the Japanese coast where as a little boy he had often played. The low square stone house was set upon rocks well above a narrow beach that was outlined with bent pines. As a boy, Sadao had climbed the pines, supporting himself on his bare feet, as he had seen men do in the South Seas when they climbed for coconuts. His father had taken him often to the islands of those seas, and never had he failed to say to the little brave boy at his side, "Those islands yonder, they are the stepping stones to the future for Japan." "Where shall we stay from them?" Sadao had asked seriously. "Who knows?" his father had answered. "Who can limit our future? It depends on what we make it." My dear, in this paragraph we see the writer introduces the main character of the story, Dr. Sadao Hawke. Dr. Sadao's house was situated on the coast of Japan. Coast means shore of the sea. He had been living there since his childhood. The house had a low height and was made of stone. It was set upon the rocky beach, which had a boundary line made with pine trees that were tilted towards one side. When Dr. Sadao was a child, he would climb up the pine trees. On his visits to the South Seas, he would see men do so in order to get coconuts from the trees. He would accompany his father to the islands of the South Seas often. His father would point towards the islands and would say that those were the stepping stones towards the future of Japan. Dr. Sadao would question him childishly that where would they reach from those islands. His father would reply that it was not known, as it depended on the future. The future had no limits. It depended on mankind, how it shaped its future. My dear, we have to set our future. What do you want in your future? In the same way, the island which was near Dr. Sadao's house represented future, and we all know that future has no limits. We can achieve too much in our future. We cannot achieve too much in our future. The future is dark. We can't see what will happen in future. So in this paragraph we have seen where was the house of Dr. Sadao Hawke and what did his father say to him, and the main character is Dr. Sadao Hawke. Dr. Sadao Hawke was one of the most famous doctors in Japan. He was one of the best surgeons of Japan. Now write down some meanings. Spot. Spot means place. Coast. Shore. S-H-O-R-E. Shore. Set upon. Established. Outlined, stood in rows, R-O-W-S, rows. Supporting, holding up. Yonder means there. stepping stones means first steps, limit, restrict. Now see the next paragraph. Sadao had taken this into his mind as he did everything his father said. His father, who never joked or played with him, but who spent infinite pains upon him, who was his only son. Sadao knew that his education was his father's chief concern. For this reason, he had been sent at 22 to America to learn all that could be learned of surgery and medicine. He had come back at 30, and before his father died, he had seen Sadao become famous not only as a surgeon but as a scientist, because he was perfecting a discovery which would render wounds entirely clean. He had not been sent abroad with the troops. Also, he knew there was some slight danger that the old general might need an operation for a condition for which he was now being treated medically, and for this possibility, Sadao was being kept in Japan. In this paragraph, what we see? We see Sadao retained all the things that his father would tell him as a child. His father never played or joked with him. Some fathers are very strict. Some fathers only want result from their sons and daughters. They do not play with them. They do not joke with them. They shared a mature relation, and his father underwent a lot of hardships to bring him up. Sadao knew that his father was concerned about his education. Every father is worried, every father thinks about his son's education, his daughter's education. Sadao's father was one of them. He was sent to America at the age of 22 to study surgery and medicine. He returned at the age of 30. It means he lived in America for 8 years. To learn surgery and medicine. Before dying, Sadao's father saw Sadao become famous not only as a surgeon but also as a scientist. Sadao was on his way to discover a treatment for wounds which would make them absolutely clean. So he was not sent abroad with the armed forces as a doctor. Also, he was retained in Japan because the old general was suffering from an ailment, from a disease which needed to be operated upon in case of an emergency. From this paragraph, the question will be asked: what were the chief concern of Dr. Sadao's father? Dr. Sadao's father's chief concern was to educate his son well. And my dear, in this paragraph we have seen, before dying, Dr. Sadao became a famous surgeon in Japan, and he was not sent with the armed forces as a doctor. He was kept in Japan. Why? Because there was an old general who was suffering from disease which needed to be operated upon in case of an emergency. So, for the treatment of old general, Dr. Sadao was kept in Japan to see him in the moment of need. Now, write down its meaning here. Infinite means endless. Chief means main, M-A-I-N. Concern means worry, chinta. Surgery, the science of performing operations on the body. Perfecting means nearing completion. Render means make. Entirely, completely. Troops, soldiers. Slight, little. Treated, got treatment. Unexpected, not hoped before. Warmth means heat. Now see the next paragraph. Clouds were rising from the ocean now. The unexpected warmth of the past few days had at night drawn heavy fog from the cold waves. Sadao watched mists hide outlines of a little island near the shore and then come creeping up the beach below the house. Writhing around the pines, in a few minutes fog would be wrapped about the house too. Then he would go into the room where Hana, his wife, would be waiting for him with the two children. Here see, Hana was his wife. Here we see the writer describes the scene outside Dr. Sadao's house. As the days were unusually warm and the sea waves were cold, the nights became foggy. Dr. Sadao saw the boundary of a nearby island became invisible gradually as it got covered in the mist. Slowly the mist was coming closer to him. Soon there would be mist all around his house. At that time, he would go back into the house to his wife Hana, who was waiting for him along with their two children. In this paragraph, we see the scene around Dr. Sadao's house and about his wife. His wife's name was Hana, and they had two children after their marriage. Now, write down meaning. Mists means clouds of very small drops of water in the air. Creeping means crawling. Beach, sea coast. Writhing, winding around. Fog, thick mist, wrapped, covered around. Now, the next paragraph. But at this moment, the door opened and she looked out. a dark blue woolen haroi over her kimono. She came to him affectionately and put her arm through his as he stood, smiled and said nothing. He had met Hannah in America, but he had waited to fall in love with her until he was sure she was Japanese. His father would never have received her unless she had been pure in her race. He wondered often whom he would have married if he had not met Hannah, and by what luck he had found her in the most casual way, by chance, literally, at an American professor's house. The professor and his wife had been kind people. Anxious to do something for their few foreign students, and the students, though bold, had accepted this kindness. Sadao had often told Hannah how nearly he had not gone to Professor Harley's house that night. The rooms were so small, the food so bad, the professor's wife so voluble. But he had gone, and there he had found Hannah, a new student, and had felt he would love her if it were at all possible. In this paragraph we see what we see before Sadao could go inside, the door opened and his wife looked out for him. She was wearing a dark blue colored gown over a dress. She was wearing a Japanese dress that time. It was kimono. She lovingly crossed her arm with his, smiled at him, remained silent and stood by him. They had met in America. Sadao knew that his father would marry him to a Japanese girl only, and so he ensured this before falling in love with her. Sadao considered himself to be lucky to have accidentally met her at an American professor's house. He wondered that had he not met her, he would not have got a wife all his life. It means Hannah was a nice girl. She was an obedient girl. She was an obedient wife also. He thought that the professor and his wife were kind, as they were keen to help foreign students. He was glad that they had accepted this kindness and went to their house, because it was there that he had met Hannah. Sadao would often tell Hannah that it was a mere coincidence that he went to the professor's house that night, as the rooms in his house were small, the food was not good, and the professor's wife was very talkative. If he had not gone there that night, he would not have met Hannah. At that time, Hannah was a new student. Sadao had thought that he would love her if at all it would be possible for him. Here we see Hannah, the girl his wife met in America. She was also Japanese, but Sadao didn't know when he started love with her. And Sadao decided to marry her if she will become a Japanese, because Sadao knew his father was a great patriot. His father couldn't marry him with an American girl. But when it was proved that Hana was a Japanese, then Dr. Sadao was married with her with the Japanese customs. Now write down meanings. Affectionately means with love. Race means one of the main groups that humans can be divided into according to their physical differences, means caste you can say. Casual means informal. Literally, exactly in the same way. Voluble, talkative. Heedlessly, carelessly. Beforehand, already. Now this is the time for class work. And you can also write what is haroi. Write down. A loose outer garment worn over the kimono. And what is kimono? A traditional Japanese garment. Now write down some class work. The first question is, who was Dr. Sadao? Second question is, where was the house of Dr. Sadao situated? Third question is, what was the chief concern of Dr. Sadao's father? Fourth question is, in which age was Dr. Sadao sent to America to study about medicines and surgery? And the last question is, to whom Dr. Sadao met at professor's house in America? You prepare this and show me. Okay, very good. You all have prepared well. Now it is your homework. Your homework is prepare question answer from lesson 4. You can prepare it by yourself and with the help of link which I have sent to you in the WhatsApp group. Okay. Now we shall continue this chapter on the next day. Till then, thank you. Have a nice day.